Hey, before this episode starts, I just want to do a little bonus front loading mentioning that we did a four-part review of Odie's comic Tomahawk Angel, and that will be available only on our Subscribestar. So check that out. The link is in the description below. Now, back to the normal weekly episode of Shitty Webcomics Weekly. Hello and yay!
Yay!
To
Yay!
a new episode of Shitty Webcomics Weekly. As usual, these episodes are brought to you by our delightful backers on Subscribestar. If you want to see episodes of things, go to our Subscribestar, give us money, become a paid prig. And Subscribestar is linked below. You get access to a bunch of secret videos, reviews of other comics, all that kind of extra shit that you cannot watch anywhere else. You're not allowed to, motherfucker. If you want to suggest a webcomic or ask a question, check out our Curious Cat, which is also linked below. This will probably be a relatively short episode because we're just going to cover a couple of the mainstays. This one, the latest Sunday Sinfest, which has nothing new compared to our. We saw this and was like, "Is this last week's one?" And it's like, no. Not only that, it's Sinfest.xyz when I went there. And it's like, what? What the fuck is that? I'm pretty sure I had this bookmarked at Sinfest.com. Did he lose the rights to Sinfest.com or something? I don't understand this. Does it just miss? Does it redirect? Misdirect, perhaps? I don't fucking know. But the beginning is just panel of like goofy. It's like clown world, but then also they live, which is weirdly something that we used to make fun of the comic about. But that's fucking that's going so far back. But like Devil Girl, who's an artist, goes through things, and then Church that says
She's a
woke.
demon, but she's also a nice girl.
Yeah, she's a nice girl. Sort of like when feminists complain about nice guys. She's basically the female version of that, where it's like, oh yeah, you're a nice girl, huh? That means you're a fucking piece of shit.
Means she's a nice piece of ass.
Church has has problem hair guy, half shaved head, which I guess the problem with that is, oh, in the stained glass is like objectified women, and then so she's walking, and then she's walking,
Even
and
though, why is she even going outside?
yeah. And
You
then she's
really think
walking and
any
she's
man is
walking.
going to sympathize with you when it's like, oh man, I can't go outside because men will pay attention to me and be attracted to me, and it's I can't
My
get
attractive
it's like
whore body.
I don't give a fuck.
And
No
are
man
these
gives a
girls still
shit.
robots or something? Or they're demons? What happened to the girl robots? They were being objectified and victimized or something, and now the whole comic's just forgotten about them, I guess. For all the people who are like, oh, he's going full based, he's going against the woke
No,
thing. This
yeah,
is
no, don't
clearly
trust.
still full on feminist.
Do not trust. Yeah, exactly. Massively
He's
feminist.
full on turf rad
S
femme with that shit.
absolutely simping. He's simping it up
And then
so hard
again,
here.
I think some kind of reference to Reality Zone, which it's never even established what the
Property.
difference of that is supposed to be,
Yeah,
because there
property
isn't
of
one.
Devil Corp closed to the public. Really,
Yeah,
is
yeah.
nobody trying to get into the
So,
reality zone? But
again,
then
this
there's
comic
also a
is.
whole bunch of people with guns guarding the wall to reality zone.
Yeah, which, why? What? How come it's like there has to be an establishment of why they want to stop people from doing this, and instead it's just like, oh, bad. It's like, okay, that doesn't mean anything. But again, just weird shit, but also completely pointless. So the comic managed to go back to boring already. Because it was funny how it was going off even its own rails, and now it's just straight back to boring. So, moving on, I guess, to fucking Dresden Kodak.
Moving on or dumping this shit like the
Yes.
pile of shit it
Dresden
is.
Kodak at least still has its DresdenKodak.com fucking domain name. I guess they didn't have to change it to XYZ, but it also does say not secure, which I think is just a statement of Aaron Diaz being an insecure person.
Fucking, it's not Aaron, it's Aaron.
He changed
his name. He changed his name so he could more effectively cosplay as the gender he wasn't born as.
Anyways,
that his chromosomes aren't.
Returning to hot muscle chick with big sword, sort of like either Final Fantasy VII or Transistor, maybe. Except not really, of course.
Really, not really.
But then these people with, like, sort of devil masks or not are like, can't believe they turned her down. Morningstar says sooner imagine the... And,
Morning of course, Star they, oh no, I can't believe, I can't believe they turned her down. Isn't she supposed to be the ultimate Mary Sue? Oh, she's so put upon because yeah,
she has somebody, such a hard life.
Somebody didn't like her for one moment.
But then she summons a fire with her hand and they're like, whoa. And then, there's so many, but I
thought... Well, she's actually a really amazing Mary Sue.
She's such a Mary Sue that she's a Mary Sue.
She's still a Mary Sue, though.
Our
no matter how much arrangement that's the thing is the that's Nephilim. One of the important things that people really need to understand nowadays is that just because you're trying to dress up your Mary Sue so that they're more put upon, it doesn't mean they're not a Mary Sue.
Usually makes a it more lot of people Mary don't Sue get that. That's like, look at how hard their lives. It's the pity party of one, but for Mary Sue's, you see.
But that's the thing is, none of these people can figure out how to make these characters not Mary Sue's. They cannot square the circle.
There's also...
They don't comprehend it.
This, speaking of which, this page is still incomprehensible. She summons a fire and then, whoa, and then Azra, look. But she seems... This person in the background seems to be pointing to this giant crowd. So not the fire or something?
I didn't even see that. I didn't see any of that.
Because it's
going from panel to panel, yes. I didn't see a single one of those things.
It's incoherent to see what you're supposed. There's no proper focus on what you're supposed to be looking at. But again, it's like, okay, she summoned a fire. Is that supposed to be special? What's it for?
All I'm
it
does seeing, is I'm make
color fire. Around her.
I'm seeing the fire color her the area around her and her very nice fun bags.
Yeah, but for what purpose in the story? What's the purpose of this fire making the color around her? Why'd she do that? What's it doing? Why is it doing it?
That is way more important to this as far as
Dresden Kodak has never answered questions. It's always had just random shit like this and never answered why you're supposed to care. It's just random shit and then who cares?
The thing is, maybe more importantly, is just the amount of pretense surrounding this shit. This extremely florid tortured dialogue.
Our rulers have an arrangement with the Nephilim, the common Nephilim. Folk. Do not, you see, she's so much better than just the common folk.
The normie pig cattle.
Which she's are not, the Nephilim not common folk, then? What's the difference? What is the difference?
What is the difference between Courtney Love? What is the difference between Courtney Love and the American flag?
We're not fools. Living in fear isn't living. Okay, so who cares?
Okay, thanks for that input. What does that have to do with any of
that greeting card wisdom? Thank you.
fucking, all you need now is like a fucking goofy little puppy that's looking bashful next to a smashed potted plant.
Yes, that's all that's missing from this.
That is the intellectual level of this comic. It's trying to be like more than that. It's trying to be so important sounding, and it's not. It's failing.
Well, here's also who doesn't know the songs of giants that are in victories in the north. The
great do you not know?
Strike down a giant in a single blow.
Of course, we know this as the reader. We know all about that. Even though it wasn't ever shown.
Yeah, and so she fears nothing, and she says, titles don't suit me. I'm just a sword. Wow, she's so humble. She should point out how humble she is. Oh, she just did.
She should lean into that whole fucking humble
again element. I haven't been reading this for a while, but yeah, she's Azra. I have no fucking clue who she is, what she has in relation to the other shit.
So this then, isn't Kimiko Thunderjugs anymore?
I guess, but it's like, people of Lemuria stand with you, but you command the flame to drive out the invaders. Is that what that is? Because it's just fucking... Is that what it's for? Because it seems completely pointless.
Really? Because I don't know if I can command a Bic lighter to drive out invaders. It doesn't seem like that big of a deal.
But where will that fire go? And then cut, and she goes, cut, and it's drawn in like almost simpler style. And it just ends with that. And it's like, none of this means anything. It has nothing to do with what came before. Because I remember we saw the previous page where it's just like girl in a house or something.
It's a bunch of incomplete ideas multi-car pileup on the fucking freeway.
Yeah, none of this has anything to do with each other. I'm sure fucking Aaron Diaz thinks it does, but it doesn't.
On the side of the pretentiousness turnpike.
Yes. Fucking, yeah, here's the previous page. Big house, this cute Lolly shows up, she has a black eye, all that shit.
These two pages have nothing to do with each other, but it's just, it really is, it's just a multi-car smash-up of disjointed ideas that have nothing to do with anything. The ideas don't even have anything to do with themselves, let alone what's on the page.
But that was always true, even going back years. Like, if I caught up with this and tried to be like, oh, so this is what's happening, it still would have a bunch of shit that doesn't make sense and is pointless and doesn't have any purpose to being shown in the comic. It's just fucking shit. So, Dresden Kodak continuing to be Dresden Kodak. I guess it's comforting to know that some things will never change even after 10 fucking years.
More than 10 years, shit. Yeah. Although on this previous page, with her black eye, she does at least look halfway Asian now.
Yeah, now she's sort of like that that old joke that Nick Mullen did where he's like, what if I just do one eye? And he pulls it back. Like, this fucking... to make it all narrow, perhaps.
That's a better story and is way less fucking up its own ass.
That has more character development. Yeah, a fucking Nick Mullen doing a vine where he just pulls one eye back to fucking make fun of Asians. That has more character development than Dresden Kodak, than multiple pages of Dresden Kodak.
It's more endearing to the viewer than this.
Again, short episode today. That's the shitty web comics for this. We'll try and cover other ones. We do have other ones that we plan to cover. We plan to go back to the Arkhaven comics. I think we did the Big Bears Big comic in a previous episode. I'm pretty sure. I'd hope so.
I'm pretty sure. That's the thing is, like, that was so nothing. It's such a nothing comic that we can't even remember if we reviewed it or not.
I remember looking at it, but I don't remember if we even did a video about it. I certainly hope so, because if we didn't, that means we still have to, and just like, what the fuck?
We have to go back over it again.
It was like a weird journey into somebody else's mental illness, where it's like, I'm perfectly fine with leaving and never...
But not one of those creative...
Schizo.
Not one of those creative mentally ill people where it's like, oh, look at all this stuff. What does this represent? This is amazing looking. It's just like, this art is terrible, and nothing is happening from panel to panel.
Like, the serial killer from Art School Confidential legitimately did more interesting art in that movie than a lot of these fucking comic creators. But
the fucking triangles were more interesting art.
And you know how long it took to make those triangles? 25 years. ending with our good comic of the week from Shen Yung-go, the Dragon Slayer, who does a lot of cute art, but he also did this sum up of Mr. Miracle or Miracle Man and Mr. Miracle Man.
Mr. Miracle Man.
Well, he actually points out Tom King's Mr. Miracle, and it's just Mr. Miracle says, I am a sad piece of shit, and that makes me feel sad. Then blank panel, 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 blank panel. Or it's not blank panel, it's all of them just Mr. Miracle standing there blank.
So the repeated panel is just repeated again and again.
And then the last one is, I'm still a sad piece of shit, and that makes me feel sad, which is a perfect, unironically perfect sum up. I remember when people were saying Tom King's Mr. Miracle was the next Watchmen and all this shit, but this is really what fucking Mr. Miracle
total
is like.
The next Watchmen syndrome. Although in this case, it's like, why does he look like Vision?
Yeah, how come he's doing Vision? Why
Why
is your Vision
come
there? What's going on with that?
he looks like Vision?
Why come you ain't got no fucking tattoo? Why come you ain't got a tattoo? Anyways, yeah, the fucking so this week's good comic that we like and recommend is just this one that's on Twitter. That's all you need.
That's the thing. Is look how much better it is. Just some guy doing single page,
Yeah,
just
because it
a
makes a perfect
simple
point
single
and
panel,
satirical about fucking Mr.
single
Miracle.
panel gag.
Yeah.
That's all you need. You don't need to do any more than that,
You
and you can
can
blow all these other people out of the
even
water.
copying and pasting the same panel over and over again, it works when it's to make this point, too. And you know what the sad thing is? I remember I read all of that Mr. Miracle and I was like, where's the fuck? What's all the hype about? This is not even remotely as good as people were saying it was. It's very quite, it's
And but
quite
that but
sad.
that is very typical of cape weebs.
Yes, cape cucks, if you will.
Cape
Yeah, they're always
cuck
looking for the
cape.
next comic to claim is the next Watchmen, and it's never the fucking, it's not even close to Watchmen.
It's not even close to Watchmen Return or whatever
In
the
fact,
fucking
somebody was telling
sequel.
me that they just started reading some of the Stray Bullets Uber Ellis, and I was like, it's pretty good actually. It's like, yeah, you know what? This one was Stray Bullets is like by David Lapham is tragically overlooked. But I would never say, oh, it's the next Watchmen because to be honest, I kind of like it more than Watchmen. But it's a different comic, so I'm not gonna say every comic I like is the next fucking Watchmen. It's
Yeah,
really dumb.
that would be very reductive and intelligence insulting.
Reductive ad infinitum. Anyway, so wrapping up, spread the word to the inferior normie cattle that you consort with that shitty webcomics is back and actually reviewing webcomics. Donate
We're
to our
back.
subscribe star.
We're back, and we're taking ears. We're collecting our ear. We got an ear collection now.
Fucking wearing a necklace of ears. Webcomics ears.
And remember,
Streets will run red with blood. Women's blood.
for all you people out there working on your comic, just remember, work will make you free.
If you want us to plug your comic also, just link it in a Curious Cat and mention that it's a plug. Because if you just link to a comic on Curious Cat, we might just ignore it and be like, oh, I don't fucking, what is this, a comic for us to trash or something? But if you want us to plug it, we'll just say it exists.
It's a
That's all you
comic for
need.
ants.
Donate to our subscribe star, though, to get access to a ton of our super secret videos. You can suggest webcomics for us to talk about on Curious Cat. Like, share, on comment, unhit the rebell fucking, and should have listened to shitty webcomics.